Welcome back, guys. It is the GSL Team League. We are in the middle of Prime versus TSL. TSL is up 2-0 thanks to one and only TSL JYP. There he is. What a champion, man. I thought he was going to eat his headset there.
He was yawning. He's like, well, this is quite a bore. Why can't they bring out a better Zerg? He's like, hopefully Boom Fung will be a challenge for me.
He might be. Boom Fung is pretty good, man. I mean, he's shown kind of the best Zerg play on the team Prime. But you know what? If JYP loses, then we might get to see Clyde.
I know. So
we'll see.
I actually looked up on Twitter during that break. A lot of people are tweeting about the Clyde Burns.
Yeah. And hashtag Clyde Burns. Hashtag the GSL.
Yeah, hashtag Clyde Burns. Hashtag.
I want to see Clyde Burns trending, man.
Tweet at us. Tweet at EpicSoWolf and GoSuDoa.
Yep. Tweet at GomTV.
Because that way, Coach Lee will know that if JYP loses here, obviously the only choice is TSL Clyde.
That's right. We'll tell these guys who to send out next. Doesn't matter what their plans are. Our next map is going to be Daybreak.
You know what's interesting here about this is Gerard has chosen another Zerg after JYP has looked somewhat unbeatable
I know.
In PvZ. And that means he's really confident in Pum Pum.
Absolutely.
I mean, absolutely confident.
And we saw two different types of games from JYP. We saw a really good standard sort of like respond, harass-oriented style in the first game. And then we saw strong timing in the second game. So he can play a lot of styles. Game 3 is starting. What style are we going to see from JYP? Will it beat Boom Boom? Here we go, guys. It is the GSL Team League. All right, here we go. At the top of the map, we have our Zerg player, the last Zerg hope for Prime. He is...
Boom Boom Prime.
Boom Boom Prime.
I hope we get to see some cool Pung Pung cheer pulls.
I know.
A lot of Pung Pung fans, man.
Yeah, people love this guy. He's definitely got a personality, we'll put it that way. And down at the bottom of the map, we have the great hope for Prodos. He is...
TSN JYP.
I really think that, especially in like Code A and things like that, the Prodos fans have a lot to be excited about.
Yeah.
They really do. There's some really good Prodos players coming up here. He's a JYP fan. That kid looks like OGS fans. Top, doesn't he?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
I was actually thinking the same thing. I was like, that guy kind of looks like Top.
I was like, Top came to... No, he didn't actually. That's not him.
It's not actually
him. It's like Top's evil twin. He's a TSL fan. Looks like gas first for Boom Boom. He's going to open with the Speedling Expand, most likely. The safest thing to do. Oh, those annoying probes are so annoying.
Yeah, he actually... nice tautology there. Those annoying probes are so annoying.
Thank you. I know that their English language good.
He actually was really annoying with his probe earlier, and a nice reply by Boom Boom. This is what you guys can do if you have your gas up and you're being harassed like this, is put the harassed drone into gas, because then he can't continue to poke at that same drone. But he is just not giving up on this.
Oh, probes are starting to get a little bit beat
up. This is actually
the
most probe harassment I've seen since I've watched Huck play, man.
I know. Well, I mean, I think this is something we're going to see more and more. I mean, there's really no reason not to if you've got the multitasking.
Well, especially if you're doing a build like this where all you have to do is make a Nexus. You're not doing anything else. You're just sitting around. And
it's really difficult to kill that probe. I mean, with good micro, you can get him away. You can recharge those shields. There's not a lot that Terran and Zerg can really do about it until you get like maybe a lucky surround or something, but then they just mineral walk out and you've lost some mining time. You're like, ah!
Four Zerglings on the way, the standard.
Yep.
The probe's actually going to go hide at the third base location.
Ah.
Now, of course, meanwhile, Photon Cannon going back at JYP's natural. It's going to be walling that off with the gateway very soon. Very
and
standard Forge Fast Expand.
Hatchery. There we go.
That's very true.
Hatchery.
He was like, looked at me and nodded. I was like, yep.
I'm just going to use one word to describe.
He like cancels and make an Evo
now.
Chamber. We're like, what?
No. Then you just say, Evo Chamber. Zerglings. Probe. Zerglings and probe. It's like a children's book about StarCraft 2 now. See probe run. Actually, probes don't run. They kind of float. Float, probe, float.
Yeah, they float. It's all right.
Are those probes' days finally numbered? He stayed alive for a long time, but if he goes on creep,
he knows he stays off creep to keep it alive a little bit longer, but in the end, doesn't even matter.
He tried so hard.
He got pretty far.
Yeah, in the end, it didn't matter, though. Nope. It's true. It didn't really matter.
Very true. Fast third going up for Pung Pung. Risky business, but Zergs have really found out that this is quite doable.
Yeah, for sure. A lot of them have made it work. I just saw Polt and Marine King just walk into the studio together now. They're like the cool kids that are always hanging out a little bit too long at recess, and they come back late to class, and they're like, yeah, we're just that cool.
Well, you got to remember that Polt and Marine King used to be teammates, and now their teams are playing against each other, so there's obviously some cool storyline involved.
Some camaraderie. Yeah, get that neutral depot.
That depot will go down to supply block Daybreak, map.
It's the fastest a Protoss has ever beaten Terran on this map.
He's only got one depot left.
Now he's dead. Oh, actually, there's one more depot, isn't it?
Yeah. If the other depot dies, the map will die, and we'll have to replay the game.
It's going to be difficult to cannon the other one. There's that fast Evo chamber. You know, a lot of Zergs have been doing that.
You have to get it, because if it's Stargate play, you need that out. Also, if there's Dark Templar play involved.
Yeah.
But more importantly, the upgrades.
And that's something that I think we're going to see a lot of Terran players do soon, too, is there's three more gateways, but get an early engineering bay for the same reason, you know, to stay safe against the Dark Templars, and you can get a quick fast plus one. I don't know why quick was suddenly the most difficult word to say in the English language
like
there.
Quack, I'm like, all right, quack. Donald.
That's right. Well, you know, if you upgrade ducks, it becomes very easy. Too bad we don't have any water units like in Warcraft 2.
Someone was talking to me about Donald Duck the other day. You know, Donald Duck never wore pants. Man. But whenever he came out of the shower, he always wore a towel. Now, why is that?
I don't know, man. He's got feathers covering everything anyway. I don't know.
Well, the fourth gateway has finished. He's adding a Twilight Council, seeming like a very similar opening to what we saw last game.
Yeah.
The question is, will he add the additional gateways and do a timing attack, or will he take a third this game?
Nope.
The Zealot running for its life wants to check for... I'm not 100% sure. Oh, he drew the Zerlings away so he could check with the probe to see if there was a fourth base. And he's going to place a pylon, and in the main base of JYP.
Uh-oh.
You guys will get a shot of it. Three more gateways. That. Same build as last game.
Yep, we are going to have
same
a bit of a timing again.
Seven gate, plus two, blink stalker, timing attack.
It's tough to stop.
It's very
pretty
tough
strong.
To stop, indeed. He's already moving on the map. I love that he used the Zealot to draw the Zerglings away so he could get that pylon up. It's the perfect place for that pylon to be. It's a pylon he can fall back to.
Look at that, and up at the top of the map, the Zerglings found the pylon at the top, but they did not find the other one. Oh, he sees units with the Zelnaga Tower, though.
Yeah, he sees these, but the Lings are going to attack, but there's so many force fields stored up here, it might not be a good time. Oh, look, he gets this pylon down. This is really scary. Blink is getting done.
We'll see. Here we go. Zealot's a little bit out of position, but the force fields are looking really good.
Meanwhile, a Dark Shrine is also going up, so that could be, of course, that could come into play as well. Yeah. Force fields go down a little bit late here.
Oh, yeah, those Zealots are actually going to die fairly quick, but not before they do some decent damage.
Yeah,
really good force fields
force
there.
Fields there. And all of these Zerlings pop out. There's so many Zerlings, but they can't engage. This is looking really bad for Pung Pung right now.
Oh, man.
Blink is almost done, but he doesn't even have any Stalkers here. He's going to try to target down the pylon, but a force field blocks the Zerglings.
Wow, the force fields from JYP have just been flawless. Every time we're like, oh, I think that was a little bit late. It's like,
no, man,
no,
this is actually,
that was a plan.
This is the end, man. This is the end for Pung Pung. He just didn't see this coming, and his hatchery is going down. But he has no answer for what else is coming, man. He's making some Hydras right now.
JYP will single-handedly defeat every Zerg player worth sending out on Prime, it looks like.
Yeah, that's what it's starting to look like. And that macro hatchery is actually going to form a funnel so he can use his force fields even better if he wants to here.
One Hydra getting very, very brave, but it will pay for it.
No
and
range
here we
on
go.
Those Hydras. Yep. Those force fields actually not the best, but... It's looking like he's just going to die here. He has Blink. He's not even having to use it. He blinks forward.
And the DT's coming in now. Should seal the deal, if nothing else is. It's dancing time. There's not a lot he can do.
It looks like
the MC Hammer dance. It's like, can't touch this.
That's what it looks like, man. And
literally
the DT is going to work on the Hydras. And this is actually the most one-sided battle I think I've ever watched.
I think JYP has beaten each one of these Zerg players even Whereas each time, oh, man, or Archons
and making the Archons mineral right line. In the mineral line. And those drones are about to be in trouble.
Yes, they will. GG! And wow, TSL JYP getting 3-0 now for TSL. And I think it's time to send out maybe not a Zerg. What do you think?
Well, I don't know. He's killed so many Zergs. Are there even any left?
No, there actually aren't, I don't think, on the bench. JYP's like, I don't know.
Well, if there were, man, they probably got up and left the studio already.
Yeah.
Look at Revival's hairstyle, man.
It's like, I don't know, I guess Protoss is just overpowered, huh?
Have you seen Revival's hairstyle? It's like, Revival's like, no. Your PVZ is so good I need to change my hairstyle because I'm afraid of you.
Well,
he's like, I know we're on the same team, but like, sometimes I'm just really scared of you because your PVZ is so good.
Well, yeah, it's frightening.
Coach Lee's like, all right, can you finish up? We're going to go eat after this.
It's like, I'm really hungry. Let's just send you out, win a couple more games. We'll make you maybe lose the fourth one so we can send out Clyburns, see what he can do. But speaking of haircuts, look at mine today. It's not as tall as it usually is.
Yeah, you don't have your Doha towel, your Eiffel
That's
tower
okay.
on your head.
I don't mind that. I need a haircut really bad. I was getting my hair done today before the cast. I'm like, I need a haircut, don't I? And the makeup lady just like, that's all she did. She just
then,
was like.
And then someone else suggested that she cut your hair and she got all nervous and stuff.
And she's like, oh, no, I can't.
I think she could probably do it.
She probably could. She does a good job. I mean, our like
makeup
and hair
ladies. Have you guys seen
us?
I mean, look at how beautiful we are.
I know.
It's not actually natural. We get all of our beauty from the makeup
lady works wonders on me, man. I got to tell you. Teenage years were not kind. That's all I got to say. Yeah, so they're good.
Teenage years were not kind?
No.
It's like something you say to someone, you like meet someone in your 60s, like, oh, the years were not kind to him. You're like very young still, and you're like, the teenage years were not kind to me. It's like, what?
What can I say, man? I just tell it like it is. I'm not afraid. It's a mosquito flying around. Ah, that's scary, man.
Well,
might have all sorts of diseases, but don't worry about that. We're going
to
find out.
I'd like to see them send out Hannibal here, to be honest. That would be my pick, but we're going to see
Hannibal.
What it's going to be. But it's going to be the King of Marines.
Marine King. Nonchalantly sauntering his way over to the booth.
A lot of pressure on Marine King here.
He's used to it, though. Look at all those handprints on the booth, man. Look at that. It's like MC just comes in and like bangs on it when no one's around for fun. What a cool keyboard Marine King has. Look at that. Checkerboard. You can play a tiny version of chess on his keyboard.
I just love these Venus flytrap hoodies that they have.
They're very cool. I gotta say, though, my favorite team jacket is the TSL jacket. I think it's very cool. I would wear one, man. I would wear one.
I would, too, if I had one.
Cool stuff. There's Marine King. Look at that. Runner-up. But you know what? He's good enough to get there. That's the thing.
Yeah.
How many people are good enough to get to that many finals?
Most importantly, look at his GSTL Season 1 record.
Yeah.
1-4. He's actually come out for his team and failed many times.
Yes, he has. Oh, Gom Wizard makes an appearance.
The Gom Wizard shows up.
He appears.
Take note, man, because he's in there. You guys don't get to see him very much, but he's actually behind the scenes all the time.
He's working his magic.
Whenever the game lags and we have to restart or something, it's because he was actually like in the bathroom and he's like, everything goes wrong. He's like, oh no. And look, Hongan is actually a Jedi.
Wow.
He's actually like Anakin Skywalker before he turns evil.
I still say he could grow a rocket mustache.
Yeah, he could, man.
I bet he could. You know?
He really could. I would agree 100%.
Not a lot of pro gamers that I see, I don't think could really like sport a good mustache, but he's one of them.
You know, I've seen Hongan wear that hoodie like that before. He actually looks really cool.
Yeah.
He looks like he is about to be a Sith Lord.
I think so. He's like, I don't know, I'm trying to remember what the Emperor says when he gets to the Death Star and Return of the Jedi, and it's suddenly failing me. It's like, everything's proceeding according to plan or something like that. Oh, no. This is so weird. I've forgotten a Star Wars quote. The world is ending. It's like almost 2012 now, apparently.
I just remember the scene before the Emperor gets there, and the little Admiral guy's like, we need more men. Vader's like, the Emperor's not as forgiving as I am.
He's like, we will double our efforts.
He makes that exact same
face, Commander. Too. I know, I was trying to like actually bring it through.
It was good.
The majesty of theater for all the viewers at home. JYP.
Marine King actually, I think, might be able to do it.
Yep.
I think he might be able to take out JYP here. Marine King, his TVP is really good.
It is.
And,
it's true.
You know, some would say his play in general is on a level higher than JYP's. I'm not sure I would say that anymore, but ooh, some JYP fangirls.
Hey, wow. She's not afraid
I've seen
to be on camera at all. That's amazing.
I've seen those signs before. I wonder if it's just the style of sign that people like to make here, or if those are the same girls doing it.
It seems like they have like sets with a bunch of different letters because they like change them during the cast too. They have, so I don't know if they made that themselves, or if they they bought it somewhere.
There's some nice signs.
Who knows?
Well, JYP is on his way to an all kill here.
Yeah, he is. He is two kills away.
Five,
it is a best of nine, so the first team to five wins the match. So we've got at least two more games here, if not more.
You know, I think choosing Marine King here is okay. I would have chosen Hannibal personally. You know, if they lose Marine King here, well, I'll get into that in a second. But if they lose Marine King here, they don't really have a versatile closing player that can do all matchups well.
Well,
using Hannibal here, Hannibal's TVP is really good, and then his TVZ is decent. So you could have pull out Hannibal. He's like pretty versatile. His TVT is not the best in the world. But Marine King, you know, if they lose him here, they don't have a good player to close out. And I mean, in one sense, it's like, well, it doesn't really matter because they need to get as many kills of Marine King as they can anyways. But,
well, there's you know, Hongen. They showed him as one of their closers. Now, he's known for being a little bit, I don't want to say cheesy, but he relies a lot on timing
his
attacks.
His style is very apparent.
He can either crush if he hits the exact right timing, or if he doesn't, he just kind of fails pretty miserably. So, you know, he is kind of a risk.
He's a dark horse, scary, solid player.
I would love to see them send out Creator Prime, actually. I think Creator Prime is going to be one of the best players on that team.
I think
very
the reason
soon.
Why they don't send Creator out is because they don't want to use him on a PvP, because that could end up badly. PvP can always just end up badly. It's true, but PvP can end up badly.
That's true. That's true.
Even if you're really good at PvP, unless you're Inca, PvP can just end up badly.
It's
sometimes
a really risky matchup to, you know, have for like your fifth match. Say JYP wins, then you don't want to risk everything on
Protoss.
A PvP.
Yeah. You want to have a Protoss that you can use. And for example, that's why in most cases, if a Protoss is doing really well and like people can't stop him, sometimes they'll just send out a Protoss because they're like, even if he's better than me, I can send a Protoss out and things might work out okay because PvP is like that sometimes. And things like that. But anyways, I think the choice to use Marine King is going to be awesome. I think we're going to see, most likely, a one barracks expand followed up with a two-based ghost time exact. What is this mosquito thing he's doing? Oh, my God. I know, we're like
throw water on him and try to get him
out
of here.
All right, we're going to be professional about this. We're just going to ignore it. But I'm like, no, it's too much. Now I scared him away. He's gone.
It's like we're talking about Stark ever, like,
you guys can see us, like, our eyes are moving around a little bit.
That would make, like, the craziest gif if someone just, I don't know, my eyes probably look pretty creepy there. But anyway, you know, this is actually going to be a really cool matchup, too, because we've got one of the new, exciting, up-and-coming Protoss players versus one of the oldest of the old school in StarCraft II, Terran players.
And he's really good at TVP.
I would agree.
His timing attack with the 2-base with the Ghost is quite, you know, it's quite known about. You know, everyone kind of knows about it, and all the Protoss, if you ask them about it, they're like, well, I'm scared of Marine King's Ghost timing attack, and I know he's going to do it, but I don't know what to do, and they just die every time. Like, they're not sure what to do to stop it, and they just lose to it repeatedly over and over again.
You know, the way that players here view Marine King, too, is very interesting. I've talked to a lot of different pro players here about Marine King, and everyone tells me the same thing. They say this kid is unbeatable online, but in person, he's a little bit easier. He gets a little bit nervous.
Yeah, everyone considers him to be an extremely valuable training partner.
Yeah,
because
he's good
does
online.
So well. He knows so many builds. He's very good.
When he just
he
like
chokes
sit
online
back
sometimes.
Here like this at home and just like
he really does
relax
and do quite
well. Yeah.
So we'll see though. Marine King obviously has always been a good player. He's almost considered like an idol in Korea in some senses. So, like if you talk to pro players about Marine King in a bad light and you're like, oh, I don't think he's very good anymore, they'll be like, no, you just don't know. And they're like get really defensive about it. It's true. Like, everyone in Korea really holds Marine King quite highly.
He's one of the only pro gamers to also branch into modeling, too.
It's true.
It's like Fabio. Like, Fabio's an actor slash model.
I've noticed
Marine
a lot
King's
of...
Like a model slash pro gamer.
Brood War players have been doing some modeling and advertising recently. I see Slayer's Boxer all over the place.
Yeah. He's on the wall at the Intel East Stadium where the Code A qualifiers are. There's like a big sign of him like on the outside there.
Yeah. Yep. It'd be a little bit weird if I went to go qualify at that stadium and there's like a poster of me on the wall.
I know. It's like the expectations are really high.
You like look at yourself for hope and you like look up and you're like you see yourself on the wall.
Like what would I do? And you like look at your poster. You're like, that's right, thanks me, and you like go to work. Yeah, I got this now. That's what he does probably. I don't know.
Well, I think we're finally ready here. The players are getting in the lobby. The map is going to be Zelnaga Fortress. It's the map that Marine King has chosen. And it's a really good map for Marine King style.
It's a good map for a 1-1-1, dare I say it. A Marine
this is
tank
also true.
All-in.
I don't think we'll see Marine King do that, but it's always an option.
Yeah, he is one of those Terran players that tends not to do that. So we'll have to wait and see. Everyone's in the lobby now. We're going to get the game started in just a moment. Of course, we want all the players to have their settings just right. We want these guys to be able to play as best they can, so it's worth taking the extra minute or two.
Absolutely.
JYP there is loading up on some vitamin C, wants to stay healthy.
Always got to be healthy to be a good pro gamer.
Oh, absolutely. Physical health equals mental health equals healthy StarCraft 2 career. This is great. Blah, blah, blah. Apparently, I need to drink vitamin C. I can't, like, talk suddenly. And the game has started. This is an important match for Prime. Who's going to come out on top? This is the GSL Team League with Doa and Wolf.